Hey everybody, this is Kevin the Postcard Guy here from Sarasota, Florida with a quick little video about an interesting card that I picked up in the most recent collection that I purchased. It's a really cool real photo postcard shown here that I originally thought was some kind of a train wreck. It looked like there were a lot of people around and I see people standing there and train people. But upon closer examination, there's a unique item mounted on the back of the train there. As you can see, there's an American flag, several flags, there's politicians. And if you look really closely, there is a bell mounted on the flat car of that train. So after some further research, I found out that the bottom of the card here is marked The Liberty Bell, 1915 at Depot, and then La Grande, L-A-G-R-A-N-D-E. The back of the card was marked The flag in the picture belonged to the Grand Army of the Republic, which was a GAR group, Civil War group, which is really cool. So I did a little bit more research on the card. I found it really interesting and dug in a little bit. And I found that in 1915, the Liberty Bell came to Oregon as part of the patriotism-raising event leading up to World War I. So the Liberty Bell was housed in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, and a lot of people on the West Coast had never seen it before. It was a long, long trip to go to see the Liberty Bell. So they petitioned the state of Pennsylvania to send the Liberty Bell on tour. And they had a lot of local school kids wrote letters, politicians wrote letters, and they were really trying to get the Liberty Bell to go on a coast-to-coast sightseeing trip. And sure enough, in 1915, that did happen. The Liberty Bell made the special 10,000-mile journey across the United States in the summer of 1915. It stopped at 275 cities, towns, and hamlets, and over a quarter of all Americans came to see it. At that time, the nation's population had just hit 100 million. Half of all families in the United States lived on farms. People outnumbered cars 50 to 1, and 30% of all households had no telephone at the time. 13% of all the people in the United States were immigrants, and Europe had just begun fighting a world war. President Wilson was trying to persuade the United States to join the war, and the public sentiment was turning against immigration. So as it was, the Copper and Tin Bell left Philadelphia on July 4th and arrived in Baker, Oregon on July 12th, 1915. So tens of thousands of Oregon people came out to gather to see the Liberty Bell. There were kids climbing telephone poles to get a better view on it. In Portland, a judge released prisoners and sent them with guards from the jail so they could see it. All types of people came out to see such a historic sight come to their local town. It was a really cool cool event. President Woodrow Wilson traveled with the bell. He sent the bell on the nationwide train tour, hoping to raise patriotism and the support for his plan to enter the World War. So this was a very cool event. The Liberty Bell Special was a custom-designed 7-car Pullman train. The very 6th car shown here housed the Liberty Bell, which was hung from a heavy oak beam under a copper canopy. At night, a generator lit the bell so people could see it as the train rushed through in the dark. It had special custom design shock absorbers so the bell wouldn't get damaged. And like I said, every time it stopped, people came out by the hundreds to see the bell. So I thought this was a very unique image. I mean, I looked online. I couldn't find very many cards of this, but it is a really unique piece of history. And really cool for Liberty Bell collectors and real photo postcard collectors. So I hope you enjoyed learning a little bit about the Liberty Bell going on tour in 1915. If you did enjoy this video, please make sure to hit the little bell icon and hit the like button as well. And that notifies you of when my next video comes up. So once again, hope you enjoyed. I really appreciate everybody watching my videos. And thank you very much.